Hello, my name is Paul Schwein. I'm a graduate student here at Harvard University, and I'm going to tell you how to run a PCR. PCR, or polymerase chain reaction, is a standard laboratory technique used to amplify a specific sequence of DNA many times. PCR has a number of applications, including forensics, DNA sequencing, and diagnosing genetic diseases. Before starting PCR, I'll need to design primers to target the region within the human genome that I want to amplify. Primers are short sequences of DNA that bind to specific regions within the genome and tell DNA polymerase where to initiate replication. So here, I have a fragment of the human genome, and in the center is the region that I want to amplify. In order to amplify this region, I'll need to design both a forward primer and a reverse primer. My forward primer will anneal here, and DNA polymerase will amplify in the 3' direction. Then I'll design a reverse primer that anneals here. And again, DNA polymerase will amplify in the 3' direction. After many cycles of PCR, the most predominant DNA product that will be present in the solution will look something like this. The sequence will exactly match my amplified region, and the sequence here will be identical to my forward primer, and the sequence here will be identical to my reverse primer. So now it's time to set up the PCR. I'll be adding the components from largest volume to smallest volume. First is water. I'll be adding these components to the PCR tube, which is very small and has thin plastic lining to enable it to change temperature quickly. The reactions also happen in small volumes so that they can change temperature very quickly. Next, I'll be adding the PCR buffer. This buffer contains TRIS HCl and KCl. And it's meant to stabilize the pH between 8.3 and 9. The buffer is at a 10x concentration, and its final volume within the reaction should be 1x. So I'm adding 2 microliters to my 20 microliter reaction. Next, I'll be adding the dNTPs. These are the building blocks of DNA, and this is what DNA polymerase is going to be synthesizing together as it creates the new strands. Next, I'll add magnesium chloride. This is important for the reaction. It's an important stabilizer for the DNA backbone. And stabilizes its interaction with DNA polymerase. Next, I'll be adding my template DNA. I'm just going to add 1 nanogram of template DNA. Next, I'll need to add my primers. I'll be adding the forward primer and the reverse primer separately. The final concentrations of these primers will be 1 micromolar, but you may need to troubleshoot this for a different PCR. You may need more or less. So first is the forward primer. And next, the reverse primer. And finally, I'll add DNA polymerase, which will carry out the DNA synthesis reaction. There we go. And once I've mixed and spun down my sample, I'll be ready to go. I just finished showing you all of the components that go into one PCR reaction. Oftentimes, all of the components of PCR, except for the template and primers that you bring in, are pre-assembled into what's called a master mix. Master mixes make pipetting more accurate and convenient and should be used when setting up multiple PCR reactions. I used a master mix to set up these three PCR reactions. Before I set up the PCR program, I want to quickly review the three steps of a PCR cycle. In the first step, double-stranded genomic DNA is heated up and separated into two single strands. This step is called denaturation, and it occurs at 95 degrees Celsius. Once we have two single strands, we lower the temperature to allow for the primers we designed to bind to the complementary regions within the genome. This step is called annealing. And in RPCR, this is happening at 68 degrees Celsius, but this may differ based on the melting temperatures of the primers you design. Then, in the last step, DNA polymerase moves in and begins replication, generating two double-stranded pieces of DNA. This step is called extension, and it happens at 72 degrees Celsius. Now it's time to set up the program. Next, I'll need to write a PCR program into the thermocycler before adding my samples. Here's the thermocycler screen that shows a schematic of the PCR reaction, with each step from left to right, and steps 2 through 4 here will be repeated within each PCR cycle. So the first step is the initial denaturation step. I want this to be at 95 Celsius, and I want this to last for 5 minutes. Next is the denaturation step within each cycle. I want this at 95 Celsius again for 30 seconds. Next is the annealing step. I'll calculate the temperature for this using the average of the TMs of each of my primers. So this will be at 68 Celsius for this primer pair, again for 30 seconds. And then the last step of the cycle is extension. I want this at 72 Celsius for 30 seconds. Then this cycle will repeat 34 times. When the cycle is over, I'll do a final extension step so that DNA polymerase has an opportunity to finish up any copies that weren't completed. So I want this at 72 Celsius for 7 minutes. And then finally, I want the thermocycler to stay at 12 degrees forever until I can come to the machine and get my samples so they stay nice and cool. Now I'm ready to add my samples to the thermocycler. I'll place them here in the center. I'll close the lid and tighten it. You may not need to tighten the lid on your PCR machine. And I'll click run. I'll come back when my PCR samples are ready. My PCR program is now complete. I expect that my target DNA sequence got amplified many times. One of the most common ways of analyzing your PCR is to run a DNA gel. You've now seen me assemble and run a polymerase chain reaction. I hope this helps you in your laboratory work. Thank you for watching.